Yeah, Shannon, who's up first?
We have an all-star lineup of calls, so we'll start with Chester.
Chester, how are you, sir?
Hey, Matt, how you doing today?
Doing good. What's going on?
Well, first of all, I just want to tell the guys there at Courtesy how much I appreciate that show they put on there. That feller and his girlfriend that come on late at night. I don't know if you've ever seen it, but it's pretty funny. I really
Chester,
do
you
enjoy
like,
watching
you like that.
That?
You like that feller and his girlfriend.
Yes, sir. It's really funny. They do a good job with that. But listen, I wanted to call today because there's been something that's been on my mind, and I'm going to try to get this out and not make anybody too upset here, because this is something that I've been just wanted to say something about, this attendance issue amongst the students.
Okay. Now, wait a minute. Let me just set it up for you, Chester. The attendance issue right now, they sold out the UK-UofL game student tickets yesterday, but it wasn't sold out first, but then they sold it out. Still a lot of tickets left for Belmont and Mississippi State. For Boise State, they filled up the eruption zone and filled up a lot. It was probably the biggest student attendance of the year at Boise State. Still a lot of tickets not used, but to the students' credit, it wasn't what it had been at some of the other games. So I think it improved, but Chester, it's still not what it's been in the past.
It's a shame, Matt. It's a shame. And I'm going to tell you whose fault it is. This is my opinion. I don't want this to come out wrong.
Okay.
But here's what I think it goes back to. This is what I think the problem is that there's been too much of an emphasis over at that school amongst Capaluta and the leaders over there about UK being a research place, a place where we come over there and do all this research. And
yes.
I think that has gotten into that student body over there, and they've got a bunch of people over there that don't appreciate sports. And we have to go over to the football games, and they march out all these smart people out there and them kids and things, which I'm fine with that. I'm happy for them to be smart and have great success and the professors and do all that stuff. But
yes.
I guarantee you, they're not marching in, you know, them basketball players into them English classes and into them science classes and saying, hey, you ought to appreciate this man. This is a man right here. This is Julius Randle. He's one of the best basketball players in the world, and
yes.
helping them to appreciate him. They're just it's this culture has gotten all in over there where we're, you know, I guarantee them professors over there and the people over there, they'd be happy if there was no basketball program over there. And that's
all right, well, let me
way down, and we got a bunch of these people coming in from other countries, which I'm fine with. But they need to learn and understand about the sports. That's my opinion about it.
All right, let me ask you a question, Chester, hang on just a second. Let me ask you a question. Now, there are people who would say that ultimately the point of a school is to educate, and that sports is a good secondary thing, but that ultimately that's what a school is about. What would you say to that?
That's bull. Well, it's true, but educate them on this. Sports. Educate them on that, because let me tell you something. It ain't so. Maybe you're gifted. You can write a paper. You can read books real fast or whatever. Well, what makes you any better than somebody that can dunk a basketball? He's gifted in that way.
That's true.
And so that's what I just think that's what I believe. And if they're going to make a big deal out of the smart people there, well, these boys are smart. They know how to break down a defense. They know how to break a press.
So you think the problem is ultimately that the UK students have become, what, too dorky? Is that what you mean? Like they're not focused enough on other things besides, like, research and education?
I think that's part of it. I think that they're bringing all these people in over there to focus on researching things, and I think what they need to be researching is the history of the UK basketball program. And there's just kids coming in over there. Matt, you know this as well as I. There's a whole lot of kids in that population over there. They don't even understand the game of basketball. They're from, you know, some other country and things. And I think that those teachers over there, and I'm not going to get into politics, but I think
don't
you and I
politics.
Both know where this is going. There are people over there
going.
That are trying to make they have a grudge against the athletics department, and they're indoctrinating those kids into thinking that sports and getting excited about a basketball team or a football team is a bad thing. It's something. It's a waste of time, and it's foolishness, and it ain't worth getting interested in. And I believe
that's
that.
Right.
I believe
Listen,
a lot
I
of people agree with me.
I appreciate you giving your opinion. Thank you, Chester.
Yes, sir. Go Cats.